just came out to the woods for some lunch I've just had. Kind of needed a bit of greenery around. I spent the last week in a hotel for work, so I needed a bit of outdoors, I think. It's quite nice and peaceful. There doesn't seem to be too many people around. You get the old dog walker, it's pretty quiet. Just get on birds and animals and things. It's nice little spot. I wasn't thinking about just doing a video about me having my lunch. I mean, I'm not entirely sure where this will go. But there's just been a few things kind of, I don't know, nagging at me. I mean, I think, I'm sure any of you watching this, we can acknowledge 2020 is just a write-off. I mean, it's weird, it actually, for me, 2020 actually started quite good. Back in February, I was in Prague, visiting some friends there. I had a whale of a time, loved it. You know, really lovely city, great time with my pals. You know, it was good. And then, right at the time I was there, the murmurings about this COVID. And increasingly, as time's gone on, you know, we've been promised, haven't we, all, oh, it's just going to flatten the curve for a few weeks, it's just going to stop it overburdening the NHS. And that was back in the spring. It's now autumn and we're still there. They're talking about putting more and more restrictions in. You know, nobody's been able to do it. I haven't been able to visit my family. I don't think I've seen my family this year. Because we're not allowed to mix households and whatever. Probably can now, recently, but then they're talking about Yorkshire having a lockdown, so you don't know. I think this is the thing, isn't it? It's like day to day, you don't know what's going to happen. It's a terrible way of living. The uncertainty. Things are being announced with, you know, few hours notice and all this. And certainly now, as I look at it, I don't think they know what they're doing. There's a lot of inconsistency. So if you're going to have a lockdown, you have a lockdown, nobody does anything. It seems to me that the areas that are most affected are probably the most important. You know, socialising, going to the pub, seeing your mates. For all the people going to the gym, I'm not into it, but I understand for a lot of people it's a big deal. And it doesn't make a lot of sense to me that you can't go to the gym and they'll send armed police round to enforce that, that you can go to the theatre. Well, there's other things you can do. I don't get it. I can't sit here and say it's the wrong approach, but it doesn't make a lot of sense, and it's not being very well explained. And I think everyone wants to know what is it that they're looking for them to say, okay, this is, it's run its course, it's over and done with, we'll go back to normal. Will we ever? Kind of feel like to get back to normal we'll have to fight for that. You know? I mean, this year, as I say, personally, it's been a write-off. I've hardly done anything, seen anyone. Still got a lot of people, you know, friends who are kind of wary of going out, you know, I understand. But it's not easy. Definitely not easy. I mean, there's an irony in the timing for me. Without wanting to kind of go into too much detail, I mean, I lived with someone for a few years, and then Christmas 2016, she left. Christmas, just to rub a bit of salt in the wound. And then, you know, off the back of that, they found out she'd, you know, she'd been having an affair and all of this. And that takes a lot to get over. Then it was like, okay, what do I want to do? So I worked hard, saved up, bought a house. So that was last year. And then it was like, okay, getting into that. Keep working, keep, you know, grafting away. And then this year was like, right, okay, I'm in a good position. Can travel, do things, go places, and then God, that took off me. And even like if we're just talking about relationships, well, no one's gonna meet anyone sat in their own home. Online, you know, it's it's difficult. It ain't easy for anyone, certainly at my age now. I mean, I'm 40 next year. And it's kind of like, well, you know, really by now I should have had kids and whatever, and it's like that opportunity just hasn't been there. That, still that part of me that feels as though that's been taken away. And I don't know if I'm quite ready to come to terms with that. I don't think I want to. You know, I mean, I'm not here to tell anyone how they should live, what's right and wrong, but we all have ideas of what we want for ourselves. So, yeah. Makes you wonder, or makes me wonder, you know, what's going to happen there. But certainly, you know, this year it was, well, having done Prague, we were, yeah, mates, we were talking about going to Croatia. You know, very beautiful country. Spend a bit of time on the beach and see Zagreb and have a look around. Couldn't do that. I was supposed to be going to Germany end of November. There was a music festival on near Leipzig, so I was going to go there. That's been cancelled because I was flying into the Czech Republic and then travelling over. I'd have had to isolate and all this, so that's all just been written off. And then, you know, sure, there's a party that, oh, well, you know, next year will we be able to? I certainly hope so. I dare say everyone does. You know, because certainly this year's been very hard. Very, very hard. Very lonely. Psychologically challenging. It's put me in some quite, in some quite dark places. I mean, I've likened it to, if you think, like in a prison to punish people, you know, in the movies. You know, they put them in the cooler, put them in solitary confinement. And that's how it's been, in a way. You know, I go to work, I do my job, see my work colleagues, but I'm just doing a job, you know. There's only really one, two people I work with who I'd say were even close to friends. I mean, even on that level, you know, it's hard at this age to make friends. See, I stayed in this area, stayed in the job because my ex had run up, not enormous, but fair sum of money on credit cards, and it had to be paid. So I needed to stay. But really, I think the ideal would have probably been to move back up north, start afresh. It swings and roundabouts, isn't it? It's hard to know what's the right thing to do. I still don't. I mean, it's been a weird, oh, coming up to 4 years. Very weird. Kind of like a lot has just stood still. Yeah, you know, it's been a funny one. Things have come into life and then they've run their course and gone out, which is fine. There's still, you know, things that I can hopefully do in the future. But it's annoying, really, when all I really want to do, excuse me, would be, you know, jump in my Defender and go and drive to Finland or something. But can you? I mean, people are doing it. I watch a lot of these sort of van lifers and overlanders YouTube pages, and I mean, fair play to you all. I think it's phenomenal what you're all doing. But, you know, it's difficult, obviously, with border crossings and things at the moment. And to be fair, part of it's paying for it. You know, I mean, for me to go from England into Europe, up to Scandinavia and across and back again, it's going to be, what, probably £1,000 in diesel, I'd imagine. And then you've got, where do you camp, you know? I mean, when I did 2 weeks in Europe, summer of 2016, and we were with my ex, and we were, you know, we were staying in four and five star hotels and chalets and all of this, and just, don't get me wrong, I don't begrudge it, I enjoyed it, but it was a lot of money. So something a bit more affordable would be better. In any case, I mean, I'll rough it. You know, I mean, I've done camping for years. I was in the Scouts and the Army Cadets, all of that. So fairly used to it. Sometimes think even here, you know, I'm planning on getting a Zeltbahn anyway, like a small triangular military tent. Bring that out here. I don't know where the land it is. Knowing my luck, I'd get shot. So, but certainly, I think I'll be keeping an eye on things. See, at least if I can get up to Yorkshire soon. Just want to get out and do stuff, go places. Even just here, if you can hear the bird song, you know. It's nice, just soothing. There's actually a robin just landed opposite me. sign of coming winter. And I'm hoping it'll be good. I mean, around here it was actually quite warm last winter. I didn't got the odd bit of frost on the car, but was it? Be nice to get proper winter weather. We'll see, I suppose. I mean, I remember traipsing to school in the snow as a kid, you know. Those days, well, it's rare now. I mean, even say it's middle of October, it's all quite warm. I don't need gloves on or anything. Even in I don't really need this. Oh, not cold, put it that way. It's quite a thick padded parka coat, whatever. It's funny, isn't it? I said earlier, you know, I've been in some dark places over the past year. Well, I mean, all my life, really, but recently, you know, it's been very difficult. But you kind of think, what is it keeps you going? And part of it, I think, is the hope that something will eventually fall into place. You know, that things will come to life again. I mean, in a way, it's almost been like a long winter. Everything's just like hibernated. Things have gone quiet, and you know, there's not been a lot happening. But things do come back to life again, you know, it's the cycle of the seasons, isn't it? And eventually things will blossom again. And I think that hope keeps you going. Hope's very powerful. You know, there are times I despair, to be perfectly honest. You know, I think, well, how can anything happen? How can things fall into place for me at my age? All the rest of it, the other considerations, but it can. It'll not be easy. You know, I mean, even a relationship, you've got to think, stuff I've been through, and anyone who I meet, the likelihood of those they have. You know, you're wary. There's a part of you that thinks you don't want to really get too involved, because if it goes wrong, you're heartbroken again. They're thinking the same thing. Yeah, it's tough. And the thing is, I suppose, you know, you do try and find a way to minimise that risk. You certainly, you know, and that's, you don't want to sort of have your time wasted. You know, I've had enough of that. You know, I've had people come along and you think, ooh, might be something here. And you invest in it and then it doesn't pay off. And it's you know, because certainly for me, when, you know, when that happens, I have to just clean slate it, because I only have so much mental space to allocate to it. So we'll see. Funny old world out there, but like I say, keep some hope going. And in the meantime, well, there's hiking and reading and music and movies. That's a part of it. I think anyone watching this, check out a movie called Arcadia. It's a British film. Very unusual, not really a movie as such. More like a... it's about like rural traditions and the effect of industrialization. It's quite interesting, thought-provoking, you know. I'm thinking as well, I need to order more books. I'm reading so quickly now. Getting through everything I need. I can't think which it is, because I read Yukio Mishima's Spring Snow and then Runaway Horses, so I need the third one. There's four in the series. I can't think what it's called. I'll find it, it's online. But I need that. And then, yeah, a couple of other books I'll be getting when they come out. I must admit, it's funny, musically, there's not a lot of music I'm interested in recently. I was listening to just a lot of classical. You know, I mean, I like Beethoven, Mozart, Wagner, Sibelius. But for modern stuff, contemporary stuff, there's not been a lot that's really grabbed my attention. I did buy the Cold Spring compilation, the Dark Folk thing. I can't remember what it's called. It's got a long title, but the first one was the John Barleycorn, and then there were four subsequent ones. I got that, which was pretty good. It was weird though, that actually. First time I listened to it, I was like, eh? And then I listened to it again, and I'm like, oh, actually, there's some really good stuff on here. Sometimes that happens. I've done that with bands before, someone's, you know, played me a track or whatever, and I'm like, yeah, alright, whatever. And then down the way, it's like, oh, actually, there's some really good stuff. There's Robin Keats. Appearing and disappearing. There's a great, I don't know who it was, but Bird of Prey just flew through. I mean, if anyone has any musical recommendations or books or movies, type a comment. Give me a like, give me a thumbs up. Let me know what more content you want. If you've made it this far, you've done well. Literally a bloke sat in the woods talking to himself. Least it's peaceful. Anyway, I think that was about all I wanted to say. Keep plodding on, let's hope this COVID nonsense goes away. And I think I'm gonna go for a walk. But if you have made it this far, thank you for listening. I hope it's been of some interest. And see you in the next one. Just a little detail here, just seeing this twig on the stump. I often see twigs in the shape of runes, not unusual, but to see feyu is unusual. So I'll take that as a good omen. You know, relates to wealth. I think the original meaning is cattle. Yeah, quite unusual to see that. Often I see alges. And often canals as well. But yeah, nice to see feyu.